Start our chapter, next chapter, linear equation in one variable. Now before starting this, we should know a few things. First one is expression. So what is a mathematical expression? It involves expression that involves constant, variables and some operators like addition, multiplication. That is known as algebraic expression. For example, you can take 2x plus 5, 2x plus 4. So this is a expression. Now see in this, like 4 and in this 5 and in this 4. These are simple the numbers. So these are known as constant term. Constant term because the value of these terms will never change. Now here this x and here also this x, this is known as variable. Why it is variable? Because the value of x here and here, it can be anything. You can put in the place of x any number, you can put in the place of x the same way here also. Now the multiple of x is the, this is multiple of x, or you can also say the multiple of the variable. This is known as the coefficient. This is known as the coefficient. So this is called coefficient of. Now if you want to define these, so you can write that the variable is an unknown number, and generally it is represented by a letter like a, x, y, n, etc. Now the constant, as you have seen already, a number without any variable is called a constant. Like again, I will tell you one more. Suppose we have 2y minus 4. So here, what is your variable? Your variable is y. And what is your constant? 4. Now, coefficient, what is coefficient? The number followed by a variable. So the number which is followed by a variable, it is called coefficient. So here the coefficient is 2. Now a term is any number or variable which is separated by the operator. Like in this example, we have two terms. The first one is 2y and the next one is 4. So there are two terms in this example. So I hope this is clear. Now the next thing is equation. So what exactly is equation? So equation is a statement which says that two expressions are equal. So see, this is expression 3x plus 5 and another expression is only 6. So that is, both these are equal. Or you can also say the expression which are separated by a equal sign are known as equation. So means the equal sign is very must, or it is needed in the equation. Now the next thing that is very important is the degree of a equation. Degree of a equation, so it is the highest power of the variable. The highest power of the variable is known as the degree of the equation. Like in this, what is your variable? Your variable is x, and here the degree or highest power is 1. So that's why the degree of this equation will be 1. Degree will be 1, because here the highest power is 1. So the highest power of the variable is 1. So the degree will be also 1. Now the next thing is types of equation by the degree, or you can also say type of expression, type of polynomials, all these you can say. So type of expression. So here the type of expression or equations by the degree. So I've told what is the degree. Degree is the highest power. Degree is the highest power of variable. Highest power of variable. So that you know already. Now we will discuss if the degree will be 0, so it will be known as the constant. Suppose I'm taking example 5. So here you can see 5. So there is no variable, that means the degree is 2. So the example of that will be 5. Now here the degree 1 is called the linear equation. That's the chapter also, linear equation. So here if this is there, so this is called the linear equation. The highest power of x is here 1. The quadratic, if the degree is 2, then it is known as the quadratic equation. So it is, suppose equation, so equal sign is also required. So here this thing, this is the quadratic equation. For the cubical, the degree will be 3. So it can be written as x cube plus 4 for 8 equals to 0. So this is cubic. Biquadratic. Biquadratic means if the degree is, next one is biquadratic. So if the degree is 4, then it is known as biquadratic. So x to the power 4 plus x cube plus x equals to 0. So this kind of equations are called the biquadratic equation. Now the next thing we have is the linear equation, as the chapter is. So you know the highest power of the variable is 1 in the equation is called the linear equation. So example is 3x plus 5 equals to 9, 2x minus 7 equals to 6. Now these are in here, how many variables are there? One variable. So you can say linear equation in one variable. But if I'll take another example, suppose I am taking this x plus y equals to 5. Here see how many variables are there? There are two variables. One is x and one is y. And the degree of both these is 1. See, both of the degrees is 1. Highest power of x is 1. Highest power of y is also 1. So this is also a linear equation. So you can say this is a linear equation but in two variable. This is the linear equation in two variable. Here number of variables. Now why we say all these equations having degree 1 are linear? Because when we will try to draw the graph of it, so the graph will always come in the form of a line. It will be as a line, like the graph can be like this, the graph can be like this. So always these kind of equations we will, in these kinds of equations we will get a linear graph, a line graph we will get. That's why these equations are also called. Now we will see how can we solve the equation. Now we'll see solving the equations. Now for this we have this equation 3x minus 10 equals to 8. Okay, so in these kind of equations what you have to do is just write down the equation, and then this is your original equation, 3x minus 10 equals to 8. Now what we will do, we have to find out x here. So these equations you have to solve for x. So here we have to find out this x. So for finding this, what we will do here, leave the x and rest we will see. So here you have minus 10. So what we will do, if minus 10 is there, so we will add 10 to both sides. Okay, now so this will become 3x minus 10 minus 10 will cancel out, so it will be equals to 18. Now what we will see, again we have seen that this is 3x, means x is multiplied by 3, and here we have 18. So what we will do here, we have to find out x only. So here in the multiplication we have 3, so now we will divide it with 3. Both sides, on both the sides we will do the same thing. So now we will divide it with 3. So what we will get, we will get x, only x left side, and on the right side we will get 6. So this is the one of the methods. We have direct method also, in which you will just write down, first write down this. Now we will take the, leave the x on the left side and take the other terms. Like here we have minus 10, so take this minus 10 on the right side. So this minus sign will change and it will become plus 10. So here we will get 3x equals to 18. Now your x will be equals to 18. Here it is multiplied, 3 is multiplied with x, so here we will divide it with 18. So your answer will be 6. So there are two methods. I will prefer in the beginning you just follow the first method, not the second one. I'm taking one more example to make everything clear. Like if we have x by 5 plus, now here again we have plus 4, leave the term having the x, so we will leave this one only, we will see this thing. So we have here plus 4, so we will write here minus 4, both the sides we will subtract by 4. So here we will get x by 5 equals to, this thing will become 0, and this will also, this will become 14 minus 4, 10. Now the next step, what will be the next step? Here x is divided by 5, so what we will do here, we will multiply it with 5. So the both sides we will multiply by 5. So now this we can cancel. So here we will get x equals to 50. So this is the answer. So these are the